Now, great things come in small packages, and this riff is no exception. It looks deceptively simple when you play it by itself, like this. Riff number four isn't made up of a whole bunch of different notes. It's simply, in the context of C, it's the C triad. It's got some sliding going on, right? It's got a rhythmic kicker that keeps happening. And it keeps rocking back and forth between the triad and some passing tones, right? And if you just have your right hand, if you just sat down on a summer day and did this, you know, a monkey could do this. Now, to take a simple riff like that, where you're just rocking your hand back and forth, and catapult it into a fantastic rhythm and blues riff that's fun to listen to and a lot of fun to play, you've got to start shifting all the accents around. That's really what makes it come to life. This is super important. Let me show you what I mean. Now, this riff is based on what's called triplets. And just like a tricycle has three wheels, a triplet is made of three separate sections of the beat. And typically, kind of old school, you count it 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. You see it on the screen there, and you can hear that I'm accenting the first part of each triplet. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Sounds like you're going to waltz Matilda around the room. It really doesn't have much to do with the blues. However, when you start throwing the accents around, it gets kind of crazy in your head, but it really makes for fantastic riffs. Now look on the right side of the screen. You can still see four beats. However, I've put different sections of the beats in bold, and you count it like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Now, it doesn't sound real musical yet. In fact, when I show it to you on the keyboard now, you may say, nah, it doesn't sound real musical there either. However, when you put it in context with everything else, it really lights up the stage. First, let's go through slow and count out those strange accents. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Stop the video and go try that. That will snap your mind, unless, you know, you're probably a genius, but it snaps my little mind. But now let's bring it up to speed and really pull those accents out, and you'll see that it starts to come to life. Here it is. All right, it's starting to come to life, but now let's go a little further. Let's put it in context with the song that we're using in this lesson. Now, the tempo is really cooking, and if you look real carefully, you'll see that riff number four is immediately followed by a riff from back in chapter 8, the long extended static riff. Let's take a look. Down by the riverside. Way down by the riverside. Stop the video, go and grab your keyboard and try and count that, and you'll see you'll be mumbling for a while, but then you'll get it. Okay, and then learn to play it in different keys. And then we're going to go on to riff number 5, and we're going to have this baby wrapped up.